Imagine not eating for 3 full days. No snacks, no breakfast, not even a sip of juice, just water and silence. It sounds like torture, doesn't it? Yet throughout history, humans have done exactly this, not out of choice, but necessity. And surprisingly, their bodies didn't just survive. They adapted, evolved, and even repaired themselves in ways that modern science is only beginning to understand. The moment you decide to stop eating, your body enters a state of quiet confusion. It wonders, where's the next meal? But deep inside your cells, a silent program begins to run, a genetic code written by evolution itself. It's a system built to protect you, to keep you alive when food is scarce, and to unlock hidden reserves of energy and intelligence. Most people think fasting is just about losing fat, but that's a small part of the story. The real transformation happens at the microscopic level, in your cells, your DNA, and even in your brain's chemistry. When you stop feeding your body, it starts feeding on something else. Renewal. Stay with me, because the next few minutes will reveal how your body transforms hour by hour. And trust me, what happens after 72 hours might completely change how you think about hunger. Before we go deeper, hit that subscribe button, because here we turn science into real-life transformation. During the first 12 hours of fasting, your body behaves as if everything is normal. It continues using glucose from your last meal, stored as glycogen in your liver and muscles. But as the clock ticks, those reserves start to shrink, and that's when your body senses that something unusual is happening. Your insulin levels begin to drop, signaling every cell that the easy energy is gone. At this stage, you might feel slightly hungry or distracted. Your stomach growls, your brain starts negotiating. Just one snack. But behind the scenes, your metabolism is shifting gears, preparing for survival mode. Your liver, the biochemical powerhouse, takes the lead. It starts breaking down glycogen to keep your blood sugar stable, releasing glucose drop by drop like a slow IV. However, after roughly 18 to 24 hours, the supply runs out. The body faces a crucial decision: panic or adapt. And evolution made sure it would adapt. Fat begins to replace sugar as your primary energy source. The body doesn't collapse in weakness. It becomes efficient. You've officially entered the metabolic doorway that separates feeding from fasting, and your transformation has just begun. Around the 24-hour mark, your brain starts to notice the shortage of glucose, its favorite source of energy. You may feel a mild headache, a wave of fatigue, or even irritability. That's your brain saying, hey, something's different here. But this reaction isn't a malfunction. It's the signal of a great transition about to unfold. As blood sugar levels decline, the liver begins producing molecules called ketones, made from fat. These tiny energy packets are pure brain fuel. Within hours, your neurons start switching to this cleaner, longer-lasting power source. Studies show that ketones not only replace glucose, but also enhance mental clarity, improve focus, and even protect against neurodegenerative diseases. What once felt like fog slowly turns into focus. You may find yourself more alert, more centered, even calm. It's as if your brain has upgraded its operating system overnight, learning to function on endurance rather than constant feeding. So while the world fears hunger, your body is doing the opposite. It's awakening. You're not starving, you're evolving. By the second day, your body fully understands the situation and takes command. With glycogen gone, it begins tapping into fat reserves, breaking them down into fatty acids that your liver converts into ketones. This marks the true beginning of metabolic flexibility, your body's ability to switch between sugar and fat as energy. Inside your cells, a fascinating process called autophagy activates. Imagine millions of microscopic janitors cleaning up debris, old damaged proteins, dysfunctional mitochondria, and even precancerous cells. Your body is recycling itself from the inside out, turning waste into vitality. Scientists call this one of the most powerful anti-aging mechanisms known to biology. Meanwhile, your energy stabilizes. The hunger pangs begin to fade, replaced by a subtle alertness and calm. You're not drained, you're lighter. The body, no longer busy digesting food, redirects its energy to repair and protection. This is the point where fasting stops feeling like deprivation and starts feeling like transformation. Your body has stopped asking for food because it's too busy healing itself. By the 48-hour mark, you've entered full ketosis, the state where fat becomes your main fuel. Your body burns it steadily, your blood sugar stays balanced, and your brain hums on ketones with laser-sharp precision. What was once hunger now feels like focus. This is when fasters describe a strange sense of mental brightness. Thoughts are clearer, emotions calmer. That's because ketones act like anti-inflammatory agents, reducing oxidative stress and promoting new neural growth. In simple terms, your brain is literally rebuilding itself while you don't eat. Meanwhile, hormones begin to dance differently. Growth hormones surge, sometimes up to 5 times higher than normal, helping preserve muscles and regenerate tissues. Insulin remains low, allowing fat to burn efficiently while stabilizing mood and energy. You've entered one of the most ancient states of human existence, the fasted, focused, fat-burning mode that our ancestors relied on to survive. And yet, this is only the halfway point. The real miracles, immune reset, cellular renewal, and longevity begin next. At around the 50-hour mark, something fascinating happens. Instead of feeling weaker, many people report a sudden surge in energy. It's paradoxical, almost unbelievable. How can your body produce more power while eating nothing at all? The answer lies in evolutionary design. Your ancestors couldn't afford to collapse during famine. They had to stay sharp enough to hunt. Your metabolism now runs on pure efficiency. With insulin low and ketones high, your cells switch to what scientists call mitochondrial optimization. These tiny power plants inside you start producing energy with less waste and more endurance. You're no longer a sugar-dependent machine. You're a hybrid engine burning clean fuel. Even your heart adapts. Studies show that during prolonged fasting, cardiac function improves, blood pressure stabilizes, and inflammation markers plummet. The body begins to protect what matters most, the vital organs. The longer you go, the smarter your energy system becomes. And here's the twist. While the outside world thinks you're depriving yourself, your biology knows the truth. You're unlocking an ancient performance mode designed for survival and longevity. If you're enjoying this journey through science and the human body, give this video a like. It helps more people discover how powerful our biology truly is. By the third day, your immune system begins something extraordinary, a full reset. Researchers at the University of Southern California discovered that 72-hour fasting can trigger stem cells to regenerate new white blood cells, essentially rebuilding the immune army from scratch. When you fast, your body starts to recycle old, damaged immune cells through autophagy. Then, once refeeding begins, those cells are replaced by fresh, efficient ones. It's as if your body hits a biological refresh button, clearing out the dysfunctional troops and recruiting a new defense force. This regeneration effect has been linked to improvements in autoimmune conditions, inflammation, and even cancer therapy tolerance. Your body isn't shutting down, it's reorganizing its entire defense system to operate smarter. Think of it this way. During fasting, your immune system stops reacting and starts reflecting. It's not about doing more, it's about doing better. While your body burns fat and powers your brain with ketones, another silent revolution unfolds inside every cell, autophagy, the process that earned the 2016 Nobel Prize in Medicine. This is your body's built-in rejuvenation system, and after 48 to 72 hours, it's in full swing. Autophagy literally means self-eating, but not in a destructive way. Your cells identify damaged parts, broken proteins, toxic clumps, malfunctioning mitochondria, and recycle them into brand new materials. Imagine every cell becoming its own repair shop, dismantling what's useless and rebuilding it into something better. This process is linked to slower aging, improved metabolism, and protection against diseases like Alzheimer's, diabetes, and cancer. It's like spring cleaning on a microscopic scale, except it happens inside your organs, your brain, even your skin. At this stage, you're not just fasting, you're regenerating. Your body is turning old into new, chaos into order, and waste into wisdom. After 2.5 days, your metabolism reaches what could be called the deep burn. Fat becomes your primary and nearly exclusive energy source. But this isn't just about weight loss. It's about biochemical mastery. When your body breaks down triglycerides from fat cells, it releases glycerol and fatty acids. The glycerol is turned into glucose for tissues that still need it, like red blood cells, while the fatty acids feed your muscles and brain. Every organ now cooperates in a perfectly orchestrated system designed for endurance. This phase also lowers insulin resistance and reprograms metabolism to favor longevity. People who fast periodically show improved mitochondrial density, meaning they literally grow more energy engines inside their cells. You're not just losing fat, you're gaining efficiency. So when you feel that lightness, that calm, steadiness, it's not weakness. It's your body remembering what it was built to do, thrive in scarcity. Here's one of the most unexpected effects of fasting. Instead of mental fog, your mind becomes sharper, faster, more focused. This happens because your brain is now running on ketones, which provide steady energy without the highs and crashes of sugar. Ketones also increase the production of BDNF, or brain-derived neurotrophic factor, a protein that supports the growth and survival of neurons. It's like fertilizer for your brain cells. Higher BDNF levels are linked to better memory, faster learning, and emotional resilience. Your mind isn't starving, it's thriving. Evolutionarily, this makes perfect sense. During famine, your ancestors needed heightened awareness to find food. So instead of shutting down, their brains switched into hunter mode, focused, alert, and creative. You're tapping into that same ancient intelligence. So next time you feel your stomach growl during a fast, remember, that's not weakness talking. That's your brain sharpening the blade. As you cross the 70-hour mark, something remarkable unfolds. Your body is no longer reacting to fasting, it's mastering it. Ketones flow smoothly through your bloodstream, providing energy to every cell. Your brain, once dependent on glucose, now runs with an efficiency that feels almost supernatural. Hunger fades, replaced by an alert serenity. You've reached biological equilibrium. Inside, your body is rewriting itself. Inflammatory markers drop dramatically. Hormones balance out. Cortisol stabilizes, insulin stays low, and growth hormone remains elevated. At the same time, stem cell activity spikes, helping repair tissues, regenerate the gut lining, and strengthen immunity. The systems that were once overloaded by constant eating are now recalibrating in silence. Your digestive organs, resting for 3 full days, finally catch up with the detox work they rarely have time for. The liver clears out toxins, the intestines repair their walls, and your microbiome, the invisible universe of bacteria inside you, begins to reset. Scientists suggest that extended fasting can even promote beneficial microbial diversity, leading to better metabolism and mood regulation. This is not starvation. This is restoration. After 72 hours, your body has gone from consumption to creation. You haven't just skipped meals, you've triggered a complete biological reboot. The moment you end your fast is just as important as the fast itself. When that first bite touches your tongue, your body awakens like a machine coming back online. Enzymes flood your digestive tract, insulin rises, and nutrients start flowing into cells that have been waiting patiently for renewal. But here's where many people go wrong. Breaking the fast carelessly can undo the benefits. A sudden overload of heavy foods shocks the digestive system. The best approach is gradual. Start with light, nutrient-dense meals like bone broth, avocado, or steamed vegetables. Think of it as teaching your body how to eat again, gently, and with respect. The first refeeding meal activates stem cells that were dormant during fasting, amplifying tissue repair and regeneration. It's a powerful moment. Your body is both cleansing and rebuilding at the same time. You'll likely notice sharper taste, heightened smell, and even emotional clarity. You're not just eating, you're reintroducing life into a system that has been completely renewed. And this is where the story turns, because once you've experienced this clarity, eating will never feel the same again. If you're fascinated by what happens inside your body during fasting, you'll love this next video. What happens to your organs if you fast for 24 hours? Science explained. It's the perfect companion to this one, showing how your body starts transforming much earlier than you think. So, is fasting for 72 hours truly worth it? Science suggests a resounding yes, but with balance and awareness. Studies show that extended fasting can promote cellular regeneration, reduce inflammation, improve insulin sensitivity, and even extend lifespan in animal models. Yet the greatest benefit may not be physical, it's mental. Fasting changes how you relate to hunger, discipline, and self-control. It teaches that energy doesn't only come from food, it comes from the body's ability to adapt and thrive under pressure. You realize that you're not fragile, but resilient beyond belief. Your body, once underestimated, becomes a source of power you can trust. Of course, fasting isn't for everyone. Those with medical conditions, pregnant women, or people with eating disorders should never attempt it without professional supervision. The goal isn't to suffer, it's to understand your body's potential when given space to heal. And maybe that's the ultimate lesson. Sometimes, doing nothing, not eating, not consuming, just pausing, allows your body to do everything it was designed to do. If this video opened your mind, make sure to subscribe, like, and share it with someone who needs to hear this. Together, we'll keep uncovering how the human body holds the secrets to its own transformation.